The key in the next kind of condensation polymers is that you've got to have two groups that can react, but then the idea is that you have to have them on each end of the molecule. So each molecule is going to be symmetrical and have two equivalent groups, one on each end. So that means that one end of this alcohol can react with the carboxylic acid to make an ester, and then this end can react with this end of the next carboxylic acid or diacid to make an ester, and so on. So we're going to condense these. Rather than adding one at a time, we're going to add them in pairs. So one will react with another one, and then we'll keep adding opposite groups. So I'll show you the first step, and then we'll see how it goes after that. So here we go. After one addition, we have the diacid group here and the dialcohol group here. So this is ethylene glycol, and this is reacting with the terephthalic acid here. So now, if you look at this, this end of the molecule can react with another ethylene glycol to continue the reaction. This end of the molecule can react with another carboxylic acid to continue the reaction. So you try and draw the products of each of those additions. I'll probably have to go on to the next page to do both of them, but you try and draw the products of each of those additions to see how the condensation polymer can keep growing. All right, now we're going to look at another condensation polymer, nylon, that you're going to work with in the lab. So we start with adipic acid, which is just 1,6-hexanediol acid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 carbons, and there's a carboxylic acid at each end. So 1,6-hexanediol acid. Then we have 1,6-diaminohexane, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons with an amine at each end. Now we're going to heat it, remove water, and that's going to cause an amide to form between the amine and the carboxylic acid. One thing to mention is that while the proton transfer reaction actually occurs first, so the amine will deprotonate this, when you heat it enough, it starts to cause the water loss between here, and that's what's going to cause these two to condense. So here's the result of one addition. So we have one amide formed here between one of the diamine and one of the dicarboxylic acid. And again, you can continue this out in either direction. We can either add another diamine over here. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or you can add another acid to the other end. So why don't you try each of those and try to add another diamine to the carboxylic acid end and try to add another diacid to the amino end. So if that's what we started with, why don't we try and see if we can draw the additions to both ends. All right, so I redrew here this piece. I tried to draw it a little bit smaller to have more room to draw, and I took off the groups on the edges so that we can draw our new pieces added. So if this piece adds to another one of the carboxylic acids, we get it extending that way. If this piece adds to another of the diamine, we get it adding here. Okay, and so this is nylon. And what we call it actually is nylon 6,6, and what we're referring to in the 6,6 is just the number of carbons in each of our two units. So there's 6 carbons in the diamine unit, there's 6 carbons in the diacid unit, so that when we make the polymer, each repeating part has 6 carbons in it. So that's why it's nylon 6,6. So this is an example then of a polyamide, because these are amide linkages. So nylon is a polyamide. The previous one that we looked at here was a polyester, because we have that group there. So if you've heard of polyester clothing, this is what we're talking about. It's polyester groups. So these are condensation polymers made from one diacid and one dialcohol or diol.